We understand that NEC has some plans for 5G, working already in Japan, but have some propositions to the operators in Brazil. What can we expect of these plans? What can you share with us that you expect is going to happen with the auction in Brazil?
Okay, I'm very excited about the auction in Brazil, but regardless of when it happens, okay, our customers need somebody like us to bring in the whole vertical, yeah, from top to bottom, from the application to infrastructure. And NEC is a unique company which can bring the IT application and also the communication infrastructure all at the same time. And we are a little bit unique because we work with many, many partners. Yeah, we don't have to actually do it all integrated, just NEC product, because that's a little bit limited. Yeah, we actually work with different third parties to bring in different applications, and that's how we proposition our value.
What do you think the conditions are in Brazil? You mentioned that the timing is a condition that we don't know yet, we're not certain yet, but what the operators are expecting, in your contact with the operators in Brazil, what do you understand are they expecting for this new generation, and what can you help them to provide?
Mm-hmm. I think in any context, operators are looking for new revenue stream, right? And not just another generation of technology. So this revenue stream is very closely linked to the different services that sit on top of the technology. NEC, especially in Brazil, has a lot of different relationships with different verticals, like financial sector, retail sector. So our, I think, idea is to connect the service providers to the different verticals and the needs and the applications that are wanted actually by such things as the financial institutions or the retail players.
Do you understand that the companies need to change somehow to absorb these new technologies or these new services? How they need to change? What especially they need to change?
I think it's the change of the mindset. Yeah, and cultural, because in the past, I think service providers needed a way of protecting themselves to be very vertically integrated. But now they have to be more open and connect each other even, or connect to different industries or even to the government. And I think we are able to help service providers in that respect based on some of the experience we have in Japan working with different players in the industry.
In this appliance in Japan, apps and new services, what is happening over there in 5G already, and what kind of things do you believe can be replicated here in Brazil?
Okay, that's a very interesting things going on in Japan right now. Different operators are focusing on different ways of partnering. For example, NTT Docomo has a platform or a laboratory program where they invite players like construction companies or security companies to come and play with the technology, develop new services. But other companies such as SoftBank is now already creating joint ventures with different players like Toyota Motor to do different 5G services of connected cars, right? So we see different ways of partnering with different companies, but what is most effective for Brazil probably depends on the company to company, and we're able to probably consult that to the service providers according to their characteristic.
And we talked about this thing of timing. Do you understand that there is some implications if we don't make this action next year and it stays for 2021? What are the consequences possible in this timing?
I can't speak for in the place of the service providers, because of course everybody has its own journey and the customers have their own journey, but it's I think probably inevitable to go into 5G as soon as possible, because it's a global thing right now already, and it's not about just people being connected over smartphones, but to connect things to things. I mean, that's happening already in especially United States and also in Japan and some parts of Europe like Germany. There are things called the localized closed 5G, which allows industry players or even local governments to develop their own closed network based on 5G. These kinds of exciting things happening, you probably shouldn't be missing, is my view.